Vernal keratoconjunctivitis, VKC, or spring catarrh is a recurrent, bilateral, and self-limiting inflammation of conjunctiva, having a periodic seasonal incidence. Sign and symptoms. Symptoms: VKC is characterized by marked burning and itchy sensations which may be intolerable and accentuates when patient comes in a warm, humid atmosphere. Associated symptoms include mild photophobia in case of corneal involvement, lacrimation, stringy discharge, and heaviness of eyelids. Signs of VKC can be described in three clinical forms, Cameron classification. Palpebral form: usually upper tarsal conjunctiva of both the eyes is involved. Typical lesion is characterized by the presence of hard, flat-topped papillae arranged in cobblestone or pavement stone fashion. In severe cases, papillae undergo hypertrophy to produce cauliflower-like excrescences of giant papillae. Bulbar form: it is characterized by dusky red triangular congestion of bulbar conjunctiva in palpebral area, gelatinous thickened accumulation of tissue around limbus and presence of discrete whitish raised dots along the limbus, Trintas spots. Mixed form shows the features of both palpebral and bulbar types. Cause: VKC is thought to be an allergic disorder in which IgE-mediated mechanism play a role. Such patients often give family history of other atopic diseases such as hay fever, asthma, or eczema, and their peripheral blood shows eosinophilia and increased serum IgE levels. Predisposing factors: age and sex. 420 years, more common in boys than girls. Season: more common in summer. Hence, the name spring catarrh is a misnomer. Recently, it is being labeled as warm weather conjunctivitis. Climate: more prevalent in the tropics. VKC cases are mostly seen in hot months of summer, therefore, more suitable term for this condition is summer catarrh ref. Pathology: conjunctival epithelium undergoes hyperplasia and sends downward projection into subepithelial tissue. Adenoid layer shows marked cellular infiltration by eosinophils, lymphocytes, plasma cells, and histiocytes. Fibrous layer show proliferation which later undergoes hyaline changes. Conjunctival vessels also show proliferation, increased permeability, and vasodilation. Diagnosis: classification. Based on severity, authors have classified VKC into clinical grades. Grade 0, absence of symptoms. Grade 1, mild, symptoms but no corneal involvement. Grade 2, moderate, symptoms with photophobia but no corneal involvement. Grade 3, severe, symptoms, photophobia, MILF to moderate SP case or with diffuse SPK or corneal ulcer. Vernal keratopathy. Corneal involvement in VKC may be primary or secondary due to extension of limbal lesions. Vernal keratopathy includes 5 types of lesions: punctate epithelial keratitis, ulcerative vernal keratitis, vernal corneal plagues, subepithelial scarring, pseudogerontoxin. Treatment: local therapy, topical steroids are effective. Commonly used solutions are of fluoromethylone, midrisone, betamethasone, or dexamethasone. Mast cell stabilizers such as sodium chromoglycate, 2%, drops 4-5 times a day are quite effective in controlling VKC, especially atopic ones. Azelastine eye drops are also effective. Topical antihistamines can be used. Acetylcysteine, 0.5%, used topically has mucolytic properties and is useful in the treatment of early plaque formation. Topical cyclosporin is reserved for unresponsive cases. Systemic therapy: oral antihistamines and oral steroids for severe cases. Treatment of large papillae: cryo-application, surgical excision, or supratarsal application of long-acting steroids. General measures include use of dark goggles to prevent photophobia, cold compresses, and ice pack for soothing effects, change of place from hot to cold areas. Desensitization has also been tried without much rewarding results. Treatment of vernal keratopathy: punctate epithelial keratitis require no extra treatment except that instillation of steroids should be increased. Large vernal plaque requires surgical excision. Ulcerative vernal keratitis require surgical treatment in the form of debridement, superficial keratectomy, excimer laser therapeutic keratectomy, as well as amniotic membrane transplantation to enhance re-epithelialization. Recently, treatment with tacrolimus ointment, 0.1%, used topically twice daily is showing encouraging results.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.